Hello all, in today's session we are going to discuss about the cavity resonator. When one end of the waveguide is terminated in a shorting plate, means ZL is equal to 0, there will be the reflections and hence standing waves will be formed. And when another shorting plate is kept at a distance 3 lambda g by 2, then the hollow, or you can say the multiple of lambda g by 2, then the hollow space so formed can support a signal which bounces back and forth between the two shorting plates. As you are having a condition ZL is equal to 0, now you can having shorting plates means your impedance will be 0, whereas you can say Z0 is not equal to ZL, and hence there will be the reflections back and forth between the two shorting plates. This results in the resonance, and hence the hollow space is called cavity and the resonator will be called as the cavity resonator. Now here we can see here, this is the V minimum voltage will be called as a V minima. This will be the V maxima. This again the V minima and so on. Okay, so if you talk about the rectangular cavity resonator, you can see this is nothing but the shape of the rectangular cavity resonator. This is called as the A, this will be called as the B, and this will be called as the T, whereas you are having a shorting plate, one here and two will be here. The waveguide section can be a rectangular or a circular. You can have a rectangular cavity resonator, otherwise you can have a circular cavity resonator. Shape may be any, either rectangular or circular. The microwave cavity resonator is akin to a tuned circuit. Now we know, if you see the tuned circuit, your tuned circuit will have inductor and it will have a capacitor. So it is akin to a tuned circuit, whereas you can have the resonant frequency 1 upon 2 pi LC. So this is the tuned circuit. So we can say the microwave cavity resonator is akin to a tuned circuit at low frequencies having a resonant frequency F0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root LC. The cavity resonator can resonate at only one particular frequency, just as a parallel resonant circuit. So here T must be equal to say lambda g by 2. Here whatever we have seen is nothing but the 3 lambda g by 2, but this distance must be, you can say, multiples of the lambda g by 2. So for a given resonator and a mode, A, B, M, N are constant. So for a given resonator, A, B, M, N are constant. So we know that our lambda c depends on this 4 factor. So if for given resonator, if these values are fixed or constant, you can say lambda c is fixed, and if lambda c is fixed, you can say lambda 0 will also be a fixed. Theek hai? But lambda 0 is equal to c by f0, and f will also have a constant value equal to F0. So which is the resonant frequency of the cavity resonator? Now let us see the resonant frequency of the cavity resonator for the rectangular cavity resonator. So we'll see first rectangular cavity resonator. So expression for F0 in a rectangular cavity resonators. So if I'm talking about the rectangular cavity resonator, we know that the rectangular waveguide, we have seen the rectangular waveguide, and for the rectangular waveguide we know the condition here. If you talk about the rectangular waveguide, H square is equal to gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon. Now this is equal to A square plus B square. Now A is m pi by A square, plus B is nothing but the m pi by B square. So if we put conditions further, or if you solve this further, like the cutoff frequency, we can calculate this like m pi by A square plus n pi by B square minus gamma square. So for the wave propagation, we have already seen that your propagation constant must be equal to j beta. So for wave propagation, you can write here gamma is equal to j beta. So if you'll put that value, and gamma square is nothing but the j square beta square, which is nothing but the minus beta square. So if you put further, omega square mu epsilon is equal to m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus beta square. So if a wave has to exist in a cavity resonator, there must be a phase change corresponding to the given guide wavelength, that your beta must have 2 pi by lambda g for wave propagation. Now here the condition for resonator to resonate. We have already seen the condition for resonator to resonate. So we have seen the condition for resonator to resonate, that your beta must be equal to p pi by t. ठीक है, whereas p is nothing but the constant 1, 2, 3 up to infinity, and whereas we know that d is nothing but the length of resonator. So if we put all these values in our equation, so substituting all this value, we can write here. So we see the our first equation which we have seen over there, that omega beta must be p pi by d, f is equal to f0, and omega will be 2 pi f0, as this is the condition for resonance. So if we'll put further all these values, your omega 0 square mu epsilon will become m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus p pi by d square. So we have put it all the conditions over there, and we have seen that this is the condition for the resonance, and then f0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi square root of mu epsilon m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus p pi by d square square root, as this value will go here, and as omega square, omega 0 is nothing but the 2 pi f0, we have taken the square root of this one. So if this is the f0, we know that 1 upon root mu epsilon is nothing but the c. So c divided by 2 pi, you can write this m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus p pi by d square square root. So general mode of the propagation in the cavity resonator are T, E, M, N, P or T, M, M, N, P. So these are the general modes of the propagation. For both T, E and T, M, the resonant frequency is the same in the rectangular cavity resonator. So for both T, E and T, M, the F0 is same in rectangular cavity resonator. So we have calculated the resonant frequency for rectangular cavity resonator, which is nothing but the F0 is equal to C by 2 pi and the square root of m pi by a square plus n pi by b square plus p pi by d square. So this is all about the rectangular cavity resonator. Now let us see the expression for F0 in circular cavity resonator. So expression for F0 in circular cavity resonator. Now we know that in the circular cavity resonator, your shape is a circular one. So here we need to consider the radius of that particular resonator. So in a circular, end plates are used to short both ends, whereas A is nothing but the radius of the waveguide, and D you can say length or height of cylindrical red waveguide. ठीक है, the condition here for the resonance will be, the condition for resonance in the circular waveguide will be beta is equal to p pi by t, same as the rectangular cavity resonator. So for a circular section we know that h square is equal to gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon h n m square is equal to p n m by a square. ठीक है, so for circular you need to know this gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon is equal to h square, n m is equal to p n m by a square. Now further solving this equation, we'll write the values of all these things. So omega square mu epsilon is equal to p n m divided by a square minus gamma square. Now we'll see the condition for resonance over here. We know that our wave propagation your gamma must be equal to j beta, and for resonance we must have beta is equal to p pi by d. And if resonance occurs we can say our omega is equal to omega 0. Now if you'll put all these things over there in this equation, omega 0 square mu epsilon is equal to p n m divided by a square plus p pi by d square. Now further solving this equation, we can write the equation for the f0. So here we have calculated all that things over there. I'll write the equation again to have a synchronization. So omega square mu epsilon is equal to p n m by a square plus p pi by d square. Now further solving, I'll get the f0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi mu epsilon p n m by a square plus p pi by d square raised to half. So f0 is equal to c by 2 pi. We know that 1 by roots mu epsilon is nothing but the velocity of light, and then this will become p n m by a square plus p pi by d square raised to 1/2. So this is nothing but the expression for resonant frequency in the circular cavity resonator. Now this is for, you can say this is for mode TM NMP. ठीक है, similarly for TENMP you will have f0 is equal to c by 2 pi p n p dash n m by a square plus p pi by d square square root. So here we have written it for the TENMP mode also. So this is all about the resonant frequencies for rectangular cavity resonator as well as for the circular cavity resonator. So in the next session we'll talk about the problems of this particular cavity resonator. So we'll stop here. Thank you.